Welcome to Premier. This session will cover approval setups. So let's get started.
Electronic approval workflows are commonly used in businesses to help them save time, maintain accurate distribution to the job, GL, or inventory, and verify the dollar amounts prior to payment. This way, you can ensure the proper approval is done by key personnel prior to posting and payment. The faster you're able to post AP invoices and purchase orders, the more accurate up-to-date information is going to be available for project management reports. This way, they can make better and more informed decisions. So let's get started. Once you log in, you'll first want to set up your approvals. Over on the left, you can click on Setup, Approval Management, and go into the workflow configuration. You can also type in Workflow in the quick search. At the top, select the workflow type. AP invoice, purchase orders, etc. Once you've selected it, you can choose what the distribution type is. So do you want to set up AP invoice approvals by job, by GL, or by inventory? Click on the green Add button to add your first workflow. It can be very generic, or you can make it very specific to a certain job or project manager, based on the conditions down below. Prior to setting up your first approval, it's important to understand two important tabs down below, the conditions and routing.
If you leave the conditions set to all, it assumes all AP invoices with any condition will be routed to the people set up in the routing tab. If you select one or multiple conditions, any AP invoices that meet those conditions will be routed to the individual set up in the routing tab. Just a reminder that if multiple conditions are set, both must be met in order for the routing to occur. Also, given that you can set up multiple workflows, if you have conditions that overlap, it will not send the document to multiple workflows, but rather use the more specific workflow defined. For example, let's say you set up a workflow for job 123 without using any of the conditions except job equals 123. However, you set up a secondary workflow for job 123 and cost type equals M. In this case, the conditions on the workflow overlap. So which workflow routing should it use? Because the secondary one, job equals 123 and cost type equals M, is more specific, it will use the workflow routing set up within here and ignore the routing set up in the first workflow. So let's go ahead and add a new workflow for AP invoicing. You can see the name is set to AP invoice by job 705. Try to be very specific with the name, so later on as you add multiple workflows, it's easy to identify with them. Across the top, you can set the conditions. You can also select them down below. So this workflow is going to be conditioned by the job number. In some cases, some companies may want to route particular AP invoices by the cost type. For example, development companies may want any AP invoices coded to development cost to route to one project manager and any construction cost for an AP invoice to be routed to a different project manager. This gives you the flexibility to do so. I'll leave all other conditions set to all, meaning any AP invoice for that job, regardless of the cost type, job type, sales category, will be routed based on the workflow setup. Notice there is a status field. At any point in time, you can set the status to inactive or discontinued if there is no workflow in process. Once we've defined the workflow name and set the conditions, let's set up the final step, which is the routing. In routing, you choose the users and the order in which the workflow will abide by. At the bottom left, click on Add. The sequence defines the order of the workflow. One will indicate that will be the first user to receive the workflow. Two will be the second person. Just a reminder that you cannot have multiple people on the exact same level. Next, select the user. This pulls from the list of users set up in the user setup. From a setup perspective, it's also important that you activate their approval inbox so they can view any approvals. You can set up as many people as you'd like under the workflow. As long as there's no workflow in process, you can easily add or delete people on the workflow at any point in time. Also, just a reminder that if anything is rejected throughout the approval, it will automatically route back to the original sender. The original sender is that person defined as the person who created the purchase order or the AP invoice. It will appear in their inbox under rejected to take further action. At that point in time, they can open it up, resend it through the workflow approval, and it'll start back from the sequence level number one and route upwards, or they can delete the workflow approval. There is also an approval override set up for AP invoices under user security under special actions. Over on the far right, there's two new fields allowing you to set dollar thresholds by AP invoice total or subcontract PO total.
So once you've entered in a workflow approval, you've set the conditions and established the routing, make sure you click save at the top of the page.
So let's quickly set up another workflow. This is an AP invoice for another job 777, so I'll condition it by that job number. However, in this case, let's dial into the features available in the routing tab that allow you to set the dollar thresholds. Let's enter in $250,000 under the invoice total. This means that any AP invoice that exceeds $250,000, again, is not equal to, but rather exceeds this amount, will only then be routed to this particular user. Next, let's enter in a value for the subcontract or PO amount. Again, this is an optional field. If we enter in $1 million, that means if an AP invoice is entered and the associated subcontractor PO value is greater than $1 million, regardless of the dollar amount of the AP invoice, it will be routed to this user. Hence, these two conditions are set as OR conditions, meaning if one or the other condition is met, it will route for approval. Next, let's set up an AP invoice approval by a general ledger account. Commonly, businesses may route AP invoices coded to a certain GL for rent expense, telephone, lease, etc., to a particular owner of a business, etc. Click Add to add a brand new AP workflow by GL account. Give it a very specific name so it's easy to identify with. Down at the bottom is where you can set up the rules based on certain conditions and, of course, the routing. Here's where you can define the workflow to be conditioned based on a certain GL account or even a financial division. In the routing, set up one or multiple users in which you want the workflow to abide by. You can also set up the conditions over on the far right. Just a reminder, if you have an AP invoice that's coded to multiple general ledger accounts, it will abide by the workflow associated to the first line entry entered in on the AP invoice. Remember to click Save at the top right of the screen. Next, let's set up a workflow for purchase orders by job. Click Add to enter in a brand new workflow. Give it a name. We'll create a unique workflow for job 705. So the conditions will be set to job equals 705. Under the routing, you can set up the users you'd like the purchase order to be routed to. You can also set up any dollar thresholds, so if the PO is greater than this amount, only then will it be routed to the individuals. Remember to click Save at the top right of the screen. Hopefully this has helped you better understand the workflow configuration. Next, it's important to make sure that you set up the proper security for individuals. As the administrator, you need to ensure that the users have access to the new screens. By default, we only add new screens to the administrator as they can control who should or should not have access to them. Also, it's important to understand that in special actions, you can set up approval overrides. This means that if an AP invoice or a purchase order is in an approval process, a user can go into the screen and override that approval. We hope you enjoyed the approval setup workshop. Have a great day.